Ohayo gozaimasu. Welcome to the Uzumaki Garage. This is another episode about the Phoenix Yellow Honda Integra Type R. I do love the look and stance of the car right now, but it's looked like this for years, so I want to freshen it up. So first of all, I'll be changing its wheels and tyres, because these ones need too much camber to make them fit. The current wheels are Raise Engineering CE28 in the OG bronze colour, and they're now discontinued in this size. They're 16x8 with a plus 22 offset, and here's their detailed specs. I'll also take on the challenge of doing the wheel alignment myself, right here in my workshop, using an app on my phone, a stainless steel ruler, measuring tape, and some string. This car came to Australia to compete in two races at the Gold Coast Indy 300 weekend in the year 2000. It's never had air conditioning, and it was fitted with a roll cage for the event. It's got an aggressive wheel alignment setup, partly for track work, but also to allow these Yokohama 225/45 semi-slick tyres to clear the fenders, and it's got 205/50 tyres at the rear. The fenders and quarter panels have been rolled and pumped out a bit, and as the car is very low, it needed 4 degrees of camber at the front and 3 degrees at the rear. This means the top of the tyres tilt inwards quite a bit compared to what I'm used to. The front tyres have wear on their inner edges, and the outside edges have no wear at all as they don't touch the road. The combination of low ride height, firm coilovers, 22 offset wheels, wide semi-slick tyres, and an aggressive wheel alignment might work well on the track or Instagram, but when I'm cruising down the street, the car tram tracks and bump steers erratically. So I'm going to change a few things to make it behave nicer on the street, while still giving it a cool new look. I might need to add a roll center and bump steer correction kit too, as the car does sit low, but I don't want to make too many changes all at once. So first up, I want to reduce the amount of camber on the front and back of the car. So I went to see my friends at JDM Yard in Sydney, and got some new silver wheels with less offset. These wheels will sit 8mm further inwards, which will allow me to stand the wheels up straighter, without the tyres rubbing on the fenders. And here I'm putting the new wheels on the car to make sure they fit over the brakes before I get the tyres fitted on them. And now I'm slowly and carefully rotating the wheel around to make sure the spokes clear the brake caliper. From the factory, the Integra Type R doesn't have adjustable camber, but my car has the Jays Racing adjustable upper control arms on the front and hard raised camber arms on the rear, so I can adjust the camber on the front and rear. I've lifted the car and removed the front wheels, so I can have a good look around and loosen the camber adjustment locking screws with a hex key. Now I'm pulling the top of the suspension knuckle outwards from the car, which will stand the wheel up straighter to reduce camber.
Okay, so that's the minimum camber angle with this adjustable arms. I'm just going to tighten it up at that, put the wheel on, lower it down, and see what I get.
I don't have a digital inclinometer yet, but until I can get one, I'm just using an app on my phone to measure the camber angle. I can't demonstrate how I use my phone app as I'm filming this video using my phone as the camera, but the way I do it is to lower the car onto the ground, push the car backwards and forwards a few metres several times, which relaxes the tyres and suspension against the ground. Then I hold this piece of alloy against the wheel's edge, open the precision level app, hold it against the aluminium, and then take a screenshot. And now that I know it's not difficult to loosen the camber adjustment locking screws, I can easily make camber adjustments without even removing the wheels, as I only need to jack up the car and reach over the top of the tyre like this. Now the front camber is done, I'll remove the rear wheels to adjust the rear camber. I'll loosen the camber arm lock nuts and adjust its length to reduce camber, as it's around 3 degrees at the moment. Then I tighten the lock nuts, replace the wheels, lower the car, and check camber and adjust again if I need to. Now the camber angles are adjusted, I'll set up some parallel string lines down each side of the car so I can adjust the toe settings. I want the strings to be at the same height as the drive shaft center, so I'm measuring that with the help of this gauge. I used two lengths of alloy pipe, about 2.1 meters long, and clamped them onto video light stands across the front and back of the car. Then I clamped string to these alloy pipes, and after a lot of slight adjustments, I had string running parallel down each side of the car at the same height as the center of the drive shafts. Getting these strings parallel takes quite a lot of time if you're doing this job on your own. So if you can, get someone to give you a hand.
So I just need to move it across 1 millimeter, and now this side's 145 too.
Once I have the strings set up perfectly and the steering wheel is pointing straight ahead, I can measure and adjust the toe settings. Working on the front wheels first, I measure from the string to the front edge of the wheel, then I measure from the string to the rear edge of the wheel. From that I can work out exactly how much the wheels are pointing inwards, toe in, or outwards, toe out. Then I evenly adjust the length of the tie rods to set the front end toe to exactly what I want. And I adjust the toe on the rear wheels in a similar way, but by using the compensator arms. For driving on the street, I want to have a little bit of toe in on the front and rear wheels. Even though the new Bridgestones are 205s, they are skinnier than the old Yokohama semi-slick rears, and they have a different shaped sidewall too. After fitting the wheels, I'm really disappointed that the tyres look stretched. To me, the front tyre fitment looks especially bad, but my main focus right now is to make changes so the car is nicer to drive on the street, and after that, I'll need to do some fine tuning with tyre selection. I've taken the car out driving a couple of times now, and the changes I've made have really improved the car's behaviour. I'm not sure if it's perfect yet, because I haven't driven it fast for very long, and I haven't driven it in the rain, but time will tell. I think the silver wheels really suit the yellow car, and maybe the stretched tyres don't look that bad. But I want to try out some other tyres to see if I can get a similar fitment as before without the car becoming unstable again. Let me know in the comments what you think about these wheels and tyres, but I have ordered some other tyres so the next episode won't be far away. But that's it for now, thanks for watching and see you next time.